Welcome to the Coach Hemi Showcase. I'm Marcus Burnett, and we have started the girls' session here on site at Boyd County High School. This first matchup is going to feature Team 1 versus Team 2. Appreciate you joining us here on SUV TV. So it is the black squad here that has scored first. 2-0 ball game here. Plenty of time left. Two running clock halves as that long jumper is off the mark. And so the ball will be brought up there by number 22. Jumper's knocked down, believe that's a three. Score that one for number 22. That's Gracie Appel out of Catlettsburg, Kentucky. And it is ruled a deuce. So that'll tie it up at 2-2. Marcus Burnett, I've got the pleasure of being joined on the mic by Coach Hemi. Appreciate you being on when you can, John. I know you have multiple courts to cover, a lot of players to watch and coach. So appreciate you joining us here as number 24, Lauren Hapgood, gets that bucket.
Marcus, if you check my Twitter bio, it says at SUVTV color commentary.
Hey.
So I take this very seriously. I always enjoy my time on here, and I think over the years I've gotten a little bit better being a color guy, but it's always fun to step on the microphone for one of my own camps and to see the kids that we've invited come in here and compete. Got a number of good-looking young talent in here, as you see. You know, Appel earlier hitting that jumper. You saw Lauren Hapgood, number 24, hit the jumper. Hapgood plays for the Midwest Takeover, a PSB family organization. So just overall, it's just a fun experience to be here.
Midwest Takeover, an up-and-coming program. We're seeing more and more through the Peach State basketball and Coach Hemingway's slate of coverage. Here we're going to have a baseline drive and a trip to the free throw line earned by Katie Engel.
Engel did some good things yesterday. She handled the ball as a point guard in the three-on-three. You see her now working as a wing. But good passer, good size, young kid. She's a 2019, plays for the Capital City Comets, another organization that is represented strong here at our showcase.
Opal already has one bucket. Turning the corner, stop and pop. Nice little baby jumper there on the attempt. The shot won't fall there for Hapgood. Team Black bringing it the other way. Extra pass is made. They lose the handle momentarily, but retain possession. And we're going to have an offensive rebound, although they could not capitalize.
Make sure that you keep an eye on number 18 out there in black. That is Kennedy Miles, another Midwest Takeover player. See her move down the lane. Had a chance to watch her at actually J.B. Buffet's Midwest Showdown presented by All Ohio. And she really made an impression with her athleticism, her versatility up and down the court. She's one that I've circled in my notes to see what she would do here today.
Nice stage to take advantage of here at the Coach Hemi Showcase. Players trying to show what they bring to the table, but also get better and continue to fine-tune that skill set. We'll have some substitutions We look at Team Black, number 10, Gracie Crisp, number 14, Lakin Atkins. Number 11, Jasmine Blankenship. Number 14, well, we already got Atkins in there. Number 15, Kylie Gilliam. And then remaining on the floor is number 18, Kennedy Miles. You take a look at Team White. Wheeling, dealing on the inside. Good take, even though the outcome wasn't what she wanted it to be. That's number 26, Leanna McNulty. She's joined by number 20, Taylor Brown. Number 28, Shalea Heath. Number 22, Gracie Opal. And there with the rock, the hard take, but unable to get the shot to go. That was number 23, Courtney Scott. Scott misses, but the offensive rebound and trip to the charity stripe will come here for McNulty. Member of the Kingsport Crushers.
McNulty did some good things yesterday in 3-on-3. Young kid, nice looking release there on the free throw. Like you said, 2021, that's just a rising eighth grader, so she's got a bright future in front of her.
For anybody that's not familiar with the camp rules, there's no glitch there on one free throw being made and 2 points being added to the score. Here in the camp setting, you make one, you get 2 points on the board. A lot of good layup attempts not staying down for both teams here early on, but you're seeing unselfish play, and sooner or later, it'll trickle down and start to fall. You get that lay in there by Blankenship.
Blankenship, a member of West Virginia Thunder Club. And that's one of the reasons why we chose this location, Marcus. A number of very talented, as you see Opel go down the lane to finish. A number of just very talented organizations. The Thunder, Midwest Takeover, Cap City Comets. We got Next.
Yeah.
Another Ohio organization. You know, these programs have a number of talented players, and we thought it would be a good location to come and let them display their skills.
Glad to be here in the Bluegrass State. Number 23, Courtney Scott with the ball. She scored the last point for them off the Gracie Opel assist. Now Courtney Scott is up top directing traffic. Flips that one up, no good. Another offensive rebound, but a jump ball as the tie-up is forced there by Kennedy Miles. And it will remain there with Team White. They'll inbound it along the baseline. Good active hands is going to be stripped away there by Kylie Gilliam. And here's Crisp. Crisp back to Gilliam. Gilliam going to try the jumper. Good work on the inside there. The shot won't fall there for Kennedy Miles, but a class of 2019 player, you look for her to get better with finishing, but good footwork, Hemi.
Took the words right out of my mouth. Normally a big kid like that, you know, she's not able to pivot. You know, you wouldn't expect her to be able to make those moves, but Miles showing that she's got some advanced footwork. She's put some time in the gym. Like you said, the finishing will come.
Here, strong rebound.
Now, what I've been impressed with is her ability to clean the glass. You see her run end to end right here. She may have double digit rebounds already.
She is making it happen, going to be the cause of a lot of headaches for opposing coaches over the next few years as she tightens up some of the finishing ability and things of that nature. But in terms of running the floor, I mean, you look at it the other night. How many buckets did Tristan Thompson get just from running the floor? Just from sprinting. Helps when you got that can find creases and thread the needle like LeBron James, but either way, a lot of his points were created just by outrunning the guy that was supposed to be running with him.
No question. Tristan Thompson is the ultimate heart and hustle guy. Gets things done around the bucket, finishes a high percentage. There's an old adage, too, that says, you know, your worst shooters ought to have the highest percentage of makes on your shot, on your team. You know, because they're only taking two footers, yeah. And Thompson is a great example of that.
Team White looking to convert there on the steal. Access denied there, getting back defensively was Heaven Prinzi, number 12. Fifty ball, they go to the floor to get it, jump ball, and it will be Team Black's ball. A couple subs are in now, number 72. There is Zakoria Russell. Russell with the ball now. Lakin Atkins with the jumper. So Atkins makes it a 2-point game, 10-8. Scott trying to match back with the jumper, rebound. Also doing a good job on the offensive glass has been number 26, Leanna McNulty, here in this game.
We've mentioned McNulty's name a couple of times here already. Versatile kid, can play inside and out.
In class of 2021.
Lefty jump shot there by number 16, that's Katie Engel.
Out of Wapakoneta High School is Engel.
Quickly the other direction, number 29. That's Carly McLeod out of Huntington.
Starting to see both teams try to develop a little bit of rhythm here. More of the layups falling. That jumper was just in and out. McNulty loses the handle. Going to be brought the other way by Russell. Russell weaving through white jerseys, nice. And is able to finish.
Like Russell's energy. Really pushes the tempo. That was a great job.
Scott, risky pass, and is going to be stolen. All over that one was number 13, Sarah Thompson. Thompson still with it.
You're standing in one spot for 2 seconds. That's too long. Let's go. Nice take.
Nice Russell. Take.
You got to love that.
Yeah.
You know, misses a layup, doesn't give up on the play, comes right back and gets us a steal.
Russell with the hustle. Creates another opportunity, and now we'll have a trip to the line for Katie Engel. Speaking of Russell, let's take a look at her finish a couple plays ago there via the Coach Hemi replay. Able to finish that one in a regular game. That's probably an and one here in the camp setting. Got to be able to eat some contact. And she's able to do that and finish.
Like Hapgood. Hapgood hits another jumper. Just so steady and solid from the shooting guard position. She's got that quick, easy release. Reminds me of your jumper, Marcus.
Oh, man. Hapgood. Hapgood's like, really? You're comparing me to the guy that's commentating for me? But no, you know, I try to knock down the mid-range as much as I can. Hapgood doing a good job. Case in point here at the Coach Hemi Showcase. We're going to have some substitutions. Mentioned Hapgood at a Midwest Takeover, another Buckeye State representative here, and several states represented, Tennessee, Virginia, of course the Bluegrass State of Kentucky, Ohio in the mix, West Virginia. Oh, Cookies. Pass broken up initially, but they retain possession. There's a southpaw jumper that's no good. As we will have some substitutions. Good with the entry pass inside. No sir, says Kennedy Miles. She ties that one up. It'll be a jump ball. Good defense there by Miles as they got it in quickly. Heath was very deliberate, tried to make a move, but by that time, Miles was all over it. Was able to tie it up. Team Black gets the stop. Gilliam loses the handle. Hapgood, nobody's yelling Wolf, but she's able to get the shot off prior to it being stolen away. Opal with the assist. The lay-in made by number 20, Taylor Brown. Brown out of St. Louis, Missouri. Always like seeing players from all over the place, Hemi. But always love seeing players from the home state of Indiana and also the Lou. They're the college home.
Yeah, we call that out-of-region kids. And Taylor making the trip from St. Louis. Putting on a good show so far.
Engel over to Miles. Miles, step back.
As you would say, butter.
Kennedy Miles, she's on a roll. Knocks down the jumper, I mean. You know, we've touched on the potential. You know, we talked about some of the areas that impress you, whether it's the footwork, the energy, you know, just the way she plays, the intensity that she brings, and there she shows off the jump shot. But answering right back is Team White. See, that was Taylor Brown with another bucket. So Brown with their second bucket, but let's take a look at that Kennedy Miles jumper. She knocks that one down moments ago. Pass out, three-pointer knocked down there by Jasmine Blankenship. That's good basketball. Miles has been the pick to click. It scored a few. Didn't try to force it there. Just probed the defense a little bit. Kicked it out. And Blankenship took care of the rest there with the triple. We're tied up at 20 apiece. Coach Robinson was asking his team who's going to stop the ball. Opal raised her hand. Comes up. Gets the steal.
Oh, look at Hapgood. So left to right. Behind the back. Good dump off.
Miles.
Some pretty good defense down there, too.
So Miles with the block on one end, running the floor. Blankenship drops it off to her. And Miles a little too strong there on the layup. You like to see the layup made there, but I like how Blankenship, she just got an assist for Miles there on her three-pointer. Rewards Miles for the defense and running the floor there. They couldn't get the layup, but good teamwork. So under a minute left to play here in the first half of this one.
Set the screen left there, ball screen. Hey, go to the block. Go to that block. Come on, up. Up on the drive, up on the drive.
Brown, she's already got a few buckets here in the first half. Can't get that jumper to go. Nice box out.
I believe that was Engel, right?
Yep, correct. Katie Engel.
Sure was. Very good box out there by Engel. Good passing cut. I mean, that's textbook right there. You might want a little bit better defense, I think, but I like good offense at least. Pass, cut right to the bucket and finish it off.
Six seconds left. Hapgood looking for somewhere to get it in. And we got a timeout. I can assure you that's the first one, and that will be the last one called here today at the Coach Hemi Showcase. You appreciate the strategy and the effort by the coaches, but for the sake of the camp, You want to keep the games rolling. So, hey, screenshot this time out. You won't see another one here in Boyd County.
Yeah, we'll have to straighten this up at halftime.
But like we always say, Hemi, you appreciate, you know, a camp tone that's not only set by the players and yourself as the director, but the coaching staff being engaged, being into it.
Right.
You know, you much rather them be looking to try to get timeouts than not being engaged and making sure these campers maximize.
No doubt.
Hey, and I say if he shows that he's been on CoachHemi.com and pulls a nice set out of here, uses the X and the O, says advantage, then, hey, all's fair. Let's see what they do with these 6.2 seconds.
Hey, there it is. There it is. Screen the screener.
Well, they got the action even though the shot would not fall. That will send us to halftime. Thanks for joining us here for the Coach Hemi Showcase, and we will be back after this short break with the second half. And the second half is underway here at the Coach Hemi Showcase. Appreciate you guys joining us here. Team 1 versus Team 2. It is indeed the second half. Give me a quick second. I'll make sure that first quarter is updated to second quarter. All right, we got the second quarter reflected on the scoreboard. I believe that last score was made there by number 12, Heaven Prinzi. Prinzi makes it 26-22. All by her lonesome. Well, they recovered. Nicely did Prinzi and Team Black. As they had to foul number 21, Mackenzie Bush, who will head to the free throw line. Bush knocks down the free throw, takes advantage of the 1-for-2 free throw opportunity. Atkins with the assist, the bucket knocked down by Zakoria Russell. Ball will leave the possession there with Team White. You can see the sun glaring through the windows here at this beautiful facility at Boyd County High School. Pretty good look there for Courtney Scott, and she knocks it down. Blankenship for three. Can't match the three by Scott. Offensive rebound. That attempt's no good. Rebound snatched away there by number 28. That's Shalaya Heath. And that was a keep the peace jump ball right there. There was no jump ball to call. Heath had already snatched it away. But a jump ball called nonetheless. Team Black will have it there along the baseline.
Make sure we got our matchups. Get there. Ah, get there. Straight up. No, that's us. Play it. That's us. That's white ball. Hey, that's a good block. Wrong whistle.
So that whistle was on the other court. A little bit of confusion, but that was good defense on the inside there by Leanna McNulty. Hasn't been easy to do that against Kennedy Miles. But McNulty more than up for the challenge. Opal out top. Over to Taylor Brown. Now Brown has it. She's guarded by Engel. Opal showing good patience now inside to McNulty. McNulty, not a lot of room to work with. Is able to get the shot off, but it's Engle attacking the defensive glass.
Help, help. That's it now. Don't give up on it.
Good take there by Russell. First attempt, no good. Second attempt, swatted out of there by McNulty. And we're going to have a trip to the free throw line, I believe, for Opal. I'll tell you, number 72, Zakoria Russell, does a great job getting to the third level. Some of her layups haven't stayed down for her so far here in today's matchup, but you keep getting to the rim, to the third level with the frequency that she does, good things are going to happen. It's a class of 2020 player, so plenty of time to improve that ability to finish. Draws a lot of attention from the defense, and rightly so. Pass inside to McNulty, who has been working hard on both ends.
See the mismatch, take advantage of it.
Not just on the glass, but also having to defend Miles, running the floor, and here rewarded with the trip to the free throw line. Can't get that one to go, and it's Russell. Russell's looking to push, beats one, only one more person to beat. Called for the double dribble, wanted to shoot it, but Taylor Brown did a good job of getting back. Russell called for the double dribble. Brown for three. This is the shot, another offensive rebound for McNulty. Pass inside to Opal. She's meted by a trio of Team Black defenders.
Hey, talk right now. Read that. Good.
McNulty wrestles that one away from Miles and is able to finish it. Good hustle. There by McNulty.
That's it.
Coming up on the 8 minute mark. Miles gonna try another jumper. That one kicks off to the left. Engle had it, but had to go to the floor to get it. And another jump ball. Thompson gets it inside. Strong take there by Atkins. She can't get the shot to go. Going to be pulled out of there by Courtney Scott. Scott floats it up. Can't get it to drop. And Shalaya Heath tied up there on the rebound. Blankenship. Now she'll get it over to Prinzi. Prinzi, that one kicks too hard off the glass. Shalaya Heath with the rebound. That one ripped away by Brown. Brown will wisely slow it up. Entry pass a little too tall for Heath. Heath wanted to post up there against the smaller Prinzi. Stop it on a dime. Able to pivot away, but can't get the jump shot to go there. Thompson, nice footwork. Shalaya Heath, the rebound and lay in. Well, you see a lot of these plays, and you know, we try to recognize some of the elements that go into this camp and the performance by the players. Sometimes it's bigger than just seeing the ball go through the hole. So don't want you to think we're selling moral victories or just blowing smoke when we recognize some of the plays that these players are making, even though the shots won't fall. You know, there's no excuse for a made layup. You want to be able to make those shots, but some of the evaluators that you see here on site are able to realize, you know, certain skill sets and abilities that these players have and how certain things come with time. And you look at a player like Kennedy Miles, we talked early on, as you see that one floated up and in by Thompson. Miles has missed some of her back-to-the-basket opportunities, but it doesn't take away some of the footwork that she has shown at a relatively young age. When you look at her still having a few years of high school basketball to play. So even though she doesn't make that jump hook or might not make that particular layup off of a nice move, you still see how she can just work on that ability to finish and still be able to add on the good signs that she's showing already. So it's not about saying, oh, that player missed this particular shot. They're no good, whatever the case may be. You got to be able to see the strengths. Shalaya Heath showing her strength there with another rebound and lay-in. And here within this game, we've seen players do some very good things. You got some class of 2018 through 2020, 2021 players involved. So some very good building blocks and still plenty of time to continue to hone in on their skills. Too many times here in the social media days, you see people fail to assess things for their face value at the time, but leave room for improvement. Get a guy like Stephen Curry, you know, when it comes to the airport test, looking at him. He said he wouldn't be strong enough. He wouldn't be able to do this, wouldn't be able to do that. As we see Miles, again, able to show those flashes of strength in the inside and the versatility. But back to Curry, safe to say he's answered a lot of the questions that critics had for him before he got to college and even before he got to the pros. Now the strength, a lot of you guys might see how Cleveland have been switching, making him switch onto that pick and roll and how they've sort of taken advantage of that lack of strength when it comes to guarding LeBron James. But I ask you, that's about 80% of the NBA that is going to have a tough time stopping LeBron James from bagging him down. That's a tall task for anyone. Approaching the 3-minute mark here, it's a 2-point game. Unnecessary turnover there as Bush was trying to get it to Gracie Opal. Thompson. Thompson too strong on the jumper. The long rebound goes out to Gracie Crisp. Russell driving baseline. She's met with resistance and fouled on the play. Foul going to go against Carly McLeod.
Hey, double A. Hey, y'all double her. You got her by yourself. You got the shooter.
Offensive rebound by Kennedy Miles, and the Midwest takeover representative taking over on the inside makes it a 4-point game here for team one. Both Miles and Engel converge on McNulty there along the baseline. McNulty will go to the line, a chance to get 2 points here with this one made free throw. Running clock scenario here in camp, so clock doesn't stop when you go to the free throw line, but you got to take advantage of the free points. McNulty misses that free throw. The class of 2021 prospect has been eating glass this entire game. Can't get that free throw to go. Thompson to Miles. Miles, no good on the shot. Good defense there by number 25, Amariana West. Like they are stopping the clock the final couple minutes or so. So if you're team two, you want to be able to take advantage of that. Miles goes behind the back, nearly loses the handle.
That's good help. Good help.
He's able to keep it.
That's it. Recover.
Russell has that shot blocked. Good defense by West.
Relax, relax, relax.
But they turn it right back over.
Speed him up, White. Let's go. Speed him up. Speed him up. Let's go. Put your feet. Let's go. Oh. Get up.
Mackenzie Bush trying to speed up Thompson. Possibly force a turnover. Very high down low. Miles passes it inside and able to will and finish is Katie Engel. And that will do it. It is a 6-point game as the final seconds will tick off. Opal will get a trip to the line before the final 0.3 seconds can run off. So 37-41 is your final score. Thanks for joining us here on SUV TV. As that will do it for game one. We'll be back with more Coach Hemi Showcase.